कंप्लेंट एक्चुअली सही है, तो उसके बाद आदमी को सबूत करना पड़ेगा कि मैं एक्चुअली मैंने कुछ नहीं किया. That I am innocent, the man has to prove, and the South African Constitutional Court upheld that. Now go to Botswana. Slowly. Sekepo. Yes. See, Botswana case is interesting because Botswana mein kai baar hua ki after the man is rejected by the woman, the lovers reject the man for some reason. In Botswana, many women were killed by men. Something like acid attack case. After the rejection, they'll throw acid in India. Something like that. Right? And the court said, go to the next slide. Yeah. It's here. Courts must play the role of the court in playing a part in stamping out domestic violence. The role of judiciary to stamp out domestic violence. Okay, turn the page please. United Kingdom, England versus Wales. Okay. Now this is on punishment. This is on severe punishment. And the man said that this is very harsh punishment. So the court said that the punishment is harsh and correctly so for two reasons. One is, आखिर तक, till the end, आपने insist किया कि आपने कुछ नहीं किया. Till the end, you remained adamant कि I have not done anything, so punishment must be severe. And second, आखिर तक, आपने sorrow नहीं दिखाया. You did not show any sadness कि आपने कुछ गलत किया, आपको कुछ लगा कि मैंने कुछ गलत किया. तो पनिशमेंट मस्ट बी वेरी हार्श इन दीज सर्कमस्टेंसेज. दैट इज द यूके केस. नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज.
आखिरी तक मतलब
केस करेक्ट केस चलने तक, सॉरी लास्ट जजमेंट होने तक आपने कोर्ट के सामने आपने अग्री नहीं किया, आपने एक्सेप्ट नहीं किया कि आपने गलत किया, और आपने डिनाई भी किया, और आपको लगा भी नहीं कि आप उदास हो या सैड हो या रिग्रेट हो. तो आई विल पनिश यू वेरी सिवियरली बिकॉज ऑफ योर एटीट्यूड इन द कोर्ट. सो यू विल गेट पनिशमेंट फॉर द एक्ट, बट यू विल ऑल्सो गेट सिवियर पनिशमेंट बिकॉज वेन यू वर फाउंड गिल्टी यू स्टिल सेड नो आई एम नॉट गिल्टी. सो आई विल पनिश यू मोर सिवियरली फॉर दैट. मेंटेनेंस एंड कॉम्पनसेशन. Turn the page. Yeah. See, this is a judgment on power relation. We say no, domestic violence is because of power relation, power imbalance. Men have more power, women have less power. So this is also a detailed judgment on the power relationship between the man and the woman. And at the end you'll see responsible for, the man is responsible for food, housing, medical contribution, incidental expenses and so on and so forth. Okay, next please. Matrimonial property. This is interesting judgment. This is a judgment where the land belonged to the husband and the parents, when the couple got married, the parents gave the property. Now, like in India, when they give the property, the presumption is that they are giving it to their son. Right? So here what the court said is that when you give property, then it will be presumed it is given to the husband and wife together. Even though the husband's family may give the property, but there are many different kinds of cases. This is a complicated issue of matrimonial property. But the court said in this particular case, right? And there are many judgments about the wife's contribution to the family, bringing up the children, etc., etc. So on matrimonial property, I think tomorrow Kirti will deal with matrimonial property in great detail. And I think Flavia is also speaking on it tomorrow. But on matrimonial property, there is scope in India to try and change the understanding of the law. So that the property belongs to husband and wife. Never mind in whose name the property is. Never mind. But the property after marriage, at the time of dissolution of marriage and at the time of dispute, will belong to husband and wife. Okay? Next, please. Botswana. Here. This decision is on the point that the wife must tolerate the husband's behavior. Wife must tolerate the husband's behavior. Like somebody said in the morning session, no, madam, aapko sirf do thappad mara, to in camera proceedings kyun chahiye? Sirf do thappad mara. So you must tolerate your husband's behavior. This Botswana High Court judgment is nice. It is totally unacceptable that a woman must tolerate the husband's bad behavior. Next, please. Custody. This is again on that point that in domestic violence cases, the court should hesitate to give custody to the father. And I think maybe also visitation rights you can look at. Just go. Yeah. The court determined that the previous judge had failed to consider the attitude of the father and the effect that contact would have on the mother and child. Next slide, please. The guidelines make it clear that in every case in which domestic violence is put forward as a reason for refusing or limiting contact, the court should at the earliest opportunity consider the allegation made, etc. So contact with the father. Next, please. Bosnia-Herzegovina. This is on... this is an important judgment. Turn to the next one. This is very important on... This is the European Court of Human Rights. This is on swiftness of implementation. If you go to court, or 6 mahine baad, 1 saal baad, aapko order milega, that is a violation of your constitutional rights, you can say. Swiftness of implementation. This is it. Somewhere here you'll see it. Yes. The swiftness of its implementation as the passage of time can have irreversible consequences for relations between the children and the parents who do not live for them. So the court must be very quick in its determination of issues. Turn, please. Now, this is a case about a woman in a domestic violence dispute. Her child was taken away and given in adoption. And you are not fit. You are not fit to... So this is an important case where the court took the child back from adoption and gave it to the mother. Yeah. Okay. Now we are going to which one is this? Bulgaria. Okay. The Bulgarian case is... go to the next part. Yeah, see here, certain degree of priority. This is again on the urgency issue. That whenever a case is dealing with custody, maintenance, domestic violence, they must deal with the cases as priority cases, urgent cases. Okay, now go to the next, please. Marital rape. In India, we are one of the few countries where marital rape is still acceptable. And there must be hundreds of cases where men are coming home drunk and raping their wives. Hundreds of cases. You please raise this issue and you will win this issue. If you take it to the High Court will, in the IPC, there's an exception to marital rape. That exception you challenge as unconstitutional, as contrary to Article 21. You'll win your case. So in every High Court, please, you do public interest petitions like this. Or even raise it in the individual domestic violence complaints. First of all is United States. It says here, People versus Liberta, correct? The court declared the marital exemption for rape. Go back. The marital exemption for rape in the New York statute to be unconstitutional. Next one, please. A marriage license should not be viewed as a license for a husband to forcibly rape his wife with impunity. So this is United States, alright? Now go to United Kingdom. United Kingdom, the Lords have overturned the common law rule which stated that marriage automatically gave consent for sexual intercourse. So in UK it went in, I think, 1992, long back. Turn, please. Now, the European Court of Human Rights, sir, managed in modern. Where is this now? SW versus United Kingdom. We finished this. Go ahead. Go ahead to the next one. Yeah, this one. This is now United Kingdom, European Court of Human Rights, SW versus United Kingdom. Got that? Okay, turn the page, please. See, it seems to us that where the common law rule no longer even remotely represents what is the true position of a wife in present-day society, the duty of the court is to step and alter the rule. Husband being immune against prosecution for rape of his wife, the idea was in conformity with the civilized concept of marriage, etc., etc., etc. Therefore, they say you abandon this idea that a husband is immune from prosecution for the rape of his wife. So that's the European Court. Now go to the next one. This is R versus H. United Kingdom, R versus H. This is on a sentence being reduced because the husband actually apologized for his action and so on. He felt remorse and so on. Doesn't matter. Come. Indian men will not feel remorse, so we don't have to go for the judgment. Now we'll go to Nepal. Now see Nepal. Tiny little Nepal. They can do what India cannot do. And see the judgment, what year? 2001, 2002. In this landmark case, the decision to recognize marital rape, what is it, as unconstitutional. So Nepal mein 10 saal pehle kareeb isko unconstitutional declared kiya, marital rape. And see the next slide. And I'll finish now. Women do not lose being human rights because of marriage. So long as a person lives as a human being, she is entitled to exercise those inborn and natural human rights. To say that a husband can rape his wife after marriage is to deny independent existence, right to live with self-respect, and right to self-determination. Beautiful judgment of the Nepal Supreme Court. Okay, now go to the Kenya case. This Kenya case is a husband coming home late at night, drunk, and raping his wife. Forced her to have sex while drunk, the Kenyan case. Go to the next thing. Next slide. In the premises, I do find that the respondent is guilty of acts of cruelty and adultery and dissolution of marriage. So marital rape was a ground for dissolving the marriage in the Kenyan High Court. Next, please. For those of you all working on refugee cases, if a person from Pakistan or from Afghanistan or any other country outside, Sri Lanka, comes to India and tells the Indian authorities, my husband or that family or my community was raping me or was subjecting me to domestic violence, then you have a right to get asylum.